Hello everyone, welcome back to Vermont Craft Tours. I'm Sarah Scully. Today I wanted to share another recipe with you all, and it's a timely one. Rick's birthday was just last week, as you can see by the smattering of birthday cards on the windowsill behind me. And so the recipe I'm going to share with you is the birthday cake that he requests every year. It's a sour cream pound cake with cream cheese frosting. And it's not for the faint of heart in terms of its caloric content, but it's very good. It's very rich, it's delicious, and it's fairly easy to make. And I first made this when the first birthday that came around after Rick and I got together, and it's been his favorite ever since. So I'll post the detailed recipe on the website as usual. The basic idea is, like with any pound cake, you're using quite a bit of butter and eggs to make a very rich cake batter. It's so thick, it's almost like thick waffle batter or something. It really doesn't flow on its own. And the trick to getting your cake out of the pan successfully, you're gonna use a tube pan or a bundt cake pan for this, is to butter and flour the pan really, really well. And that'll make sure that your cake doesn't stick in the pan. So you'll bake that off. It's quite a slow bake. You want to give it plenty of time to rise, so it's a low oven for nearly an hour and a half. And then let it cool thoroughly, and then make frosting. It's quite a dense cream cheese frosting. It's lovely. I really prefer cream cheese frosting over traditional buttercream. It has a lot more flavor and it doesn't feel like you're just eating a stick of butter. So I like that kind of tang to go with all the sweetness in the cake. It's very nice. So, and the other thing I like about this cake is that you can go nuts with the way that you're going to decorate it. And that includes coloring the inside of the cake and also the frosting itself. I've done a bunch of iterations of this over the years, and I don't know that I've documented every single version, but I've done things like split the cake batter in half and use two different colors and then kind of layer them in the pan to get a marbled effect. I've picked all sorts of wild colors. I've done multiple colors on the frosting. I've even reserved some of the frosting and dyed it a contrasting color and then used that to kind of pipe messages onto the cake. And then of course you can go crazy with things like colored sugar or sprinkles or crazy candles or whatever you want. I used to let Rick pick his colors some years, but lately I've just been surprising him with different versions. So this year's cake is blue frosting, an orange cake, and then red sprinkles all over the top. But yeah, I hope you make the recipe. Like I said, it's quite fattening, frankly, not very healthy at all. But for a special occasion, it's certainly popular in our household, and we enjoy it, and I like the excuse to make it every year. So I hope you'll find a good excuse, a special birthday or another special occasion to make it for somebody that you care about and be able to enjoy it yourself. Let me know if you do make it. Feel free to leave a comment on the video or on the blog post and let me know what you think. Cheers!